Okay, so in this video, we're going to continue on with the details on the top of the saucer. We'll also do some masking on the bottom of the saucer, and if we get to the engineering hall, if there's time left, we'll do that. If not, we'll make it for another video. I went ahead and did some pre-painting for this. I didn't need to show you that. We did all that stuff in the first video. I'll also be going through this a little faster, as now when we showed you all the steps in the first video, you're going to just be repeating those kind of steps on the bottom of the saucer. So we'll just show you how we place the masks, what to weed, and we'll continue on from there. So what I painted on the top of the saucer, we painted this front little section here. We used the light gray for this one. The next section just in front of that, we did the medium gray. We worked on the gills. They call these the gill patterns back here. The gills we painted with the dark gray. I painted this section, just as we've shown from here. We've also did the back sections, the aft sections of the bridge. Those are done in a medium gray. This section up here is also done in the medium gray. So what we do now is we have to get the masks for all these sections, and I've kind of partially weeded them. This is from sheet number one. These are the two sections on the front. We'll need from sheet number four, we'll need this section of the gill, these two sections, sorry. Now these are gonna be step one of the gill. There's actually like two steps to do the gills. So you'll need that step first. We've also got from sheet number two, these are all the rest of the sections to finish all of this area in here. And this section here also from sheet two. So these we weeded. These have lines on them, so we want to do the same thing we did on the first video. I want to install these, then remove the lines. The gills we can just put right on for the first part. Those we're going to be painting a medium gray. These sections here will be the same way we did in the first video. These are going to be applied, then we're going to remove the lines after we've applied the mask. These will be painted white. So let's do this one first, because this is the medium gray. This is the single one. Okay, I'm going to put the clear transfer tape on these parts of the gills, then we'll come right back and we'll apply them. Just bring in my magnifying glass and we can put these pieces on. Now these pieces are cut the same shape as the pattern on the hull, so you just kind of start wherever you want. We're going to start in this corner. Okay. Same thing, just start in one place. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to mask this off, and we're going to give this a coat of the medium gray, which is two parts deep gray and one part white. So I will go ahead and mask that off and give that a spray, and we'll come right back. Okay, so our medium gray has now been applied, and we're going to take the masks off because we don't need these anymore. They're only there for these little teeny sections. Okay, so we'll bring back the mask from sheet number two. We'll apply all these on top here, and then we're going to be painting the gill sections. These, what have we got here, five sections. These are going to be painted with the light gray. And again, like before, place them on there and then weed them. It's a little bit easier than trying to pull them off here. The pieces are really small, but I will get those put on, and we'll go from there. Okay, so we just finished putting these five mask pieces on this area that they call the gills. I'll just go over a few things that we did. So none of the lines you pull off until the masks are applied. Then just the same way we did the outer ring and the inner ring, then we can pull all the lines off. This first one here, these lines that are really close together and create quite a pattern in here. These are kind of, there's some extra cuts in here, so you might not be able to pull all these off as one piece, because we tried to make it one piece, but what would happen is none of the lines would be straight, they'd be kind of curved, so we had to actually cut it, have it cut in different sections, but that's the way that is. You can just see the gray that we painted on there, you can just see that below, so the lighter lines actually sit on top of that. That's why we did the gray first. Same with this section here, there's the gray line that runs in the lower section of this, and then we do the light gray over top. This section here, same thing, we pull the lines off. I would pull the lines off very carefully, especially when you get around where these little lines are going to stay the dark gray. If you're starting at the corner and it's going to start pulling off this one section here, all I did is I just held the one side, pulled my vinyl until it broke, and then went kind of pulled around it, and it stayed. This one we just did the lines, and then this section is just the two pieces that come off in the center that will be painted the light gray. Once again, the light gray is going to be the 6-4, 6-3 pale gray, equal parts of this and equal parts of white. So we'll paint all this the light gray, and we'll be right back. Okay, well, our light gray has all been applied over the mask. We can take everything off and see how it came out. Just like before, just lift up a corner, pull it off. Making sure your razor sits parallel with the hull so you're not gouging the paint. Just lift a corner. What I do is after I airbrush, I keep everything in these little containers and I just mark it. And I keep a piece of duct tape over it. This will last for almost a week without drying out, and then you can use that for touch-ups. This is where you can see the medium gray underneath. And you can see that first medium gray we put in here is just off to one side of each one of these. The medium gray is in here and across there. Okay. Well, that's that. I guess we'll move on to these sections here. We'll grab these pieces here from number two, sheet number two. I'll put the clear on here, apply them, and then we're going to do the same thing we did. With these ones, we'll pull off the lines, and then this will all be shot with the white. We can also put these two pieces on. Those two pieces will also be put on and painted white, even though there's two of them. Two different tones here, that's what we're going to use for both of those. So I'll get those on, and we'll be right back. Okay, I just want to show you again how you can use the same transfer tape over and over again. You really don't have to cut it all the time. That's only if you have problems lining it up, but you can see through it if you take your time. So I'm just going to leave the transfer tape long. I'm not going to trim around it. And like I said, these pieces are pretty close to the pieces that you're putting them on, the sections. So you can just kind of start in any corner. Just give a little tap to the next side. Smooth it out. Take the transfer tape off. I can use this for another one. All right, I'll finish the rest. I'll be right back. Okay, well, that's the remaining masks for the top of the saucer. We put these two on there and then took the lines off. And all of these pieces went on. And again, we removed the lines. Nothing different than what we did on the outer ring, so I really didn't want to go through all that, wasting that time for you. So now that we've got all that done, these sections all get painted with white. And we'll come back the minute it's all painted. Okay, well, we've applied the three coats of white over the areas we just did, and we'll unmask it, and that should pretty much finish off the top of the saucer. Okay, well, that should pretty much finish all of the masking for the top of the saucer. I got a few little areas I caught with the tweezers, so I have a few little areas to do some little touch-up paint, but that's to be expected when you're doing something this small. All right, well, that's the top of the saucer completed. Okay, so I went ahead and painted the lower part, or the underside of the saucer. Didn't need to show you that. That was done in the first video, so I just went ahead and did it. We have the dark brown, or sorry, the dark gray on these gill sections, and then everything else is the medium gray. The outside, we painted each one of those panels just like we did on the top, only with the medium gray. Second ring is left white. Third, fourth ring are the medium gray. Fifth ring is white. And then it's inside's all medium gray. So that's that. So the sheets we'll need for that are sheet 6. And I've already gone ahead and weeded this for you, so you didn't have to go through that. Also, we need a couple pieces from sheet number 5. Now, I know this looks like a lot of weeding. I timed myself doing this. I had all these two sheets weeded in 20 minutes. So it looks like a daunting task, but it's really not that bad. One thing I'm going to go over is when you're doing the outer ring, if you're doing pieces that are fairly small, in other words, all of the outer ring, you can probably do it without the transfer tape. I will be giving you enough transfer tape to use if you so wish, but if you want to just lay them on, it's just as easy. I'll show you that. The other nice thing about the lower saucer, it should go a little quicker. The lower saucer only has the Aztec pattern. It doesn't have those lines that we had to remove on the top. So really the patterns we're going to be looking at are just kind of this kind of pattern in here. So if you don't get the masks absolutely laid out to where we're telling you to start them and continue on, it's not a big issue. You're just creating a pattern. So let me just show you what I was talking about not using transfer tape if you don't want to. These pieces here, if you slide, just like we're peeling off the hull, if you slide the razor knife right next to the wax paper and just slide underneath here and peel this off, it stays fairly rigid because there's a lot of cut on it, but it's still delicate, but you can still handle it. So all I do is I just pulled it off with the knife and then put it on a set of tweezers. And I'm just going to bring my magnifying glass in here because I can't see this. And just kind of lay it over top of the section, wherever you want to start, and tap it down. Like I said, all we're doing is we're just creating this pattern. There's no lines to do. So we'll do a couple more here. So just pull it off, pick it up with the tweezers. lay it in place. I'm going to go ahead and finish up the outer ring, and then I'll come back and I'll show you where we start with these other rings. Okay, so the outer ring's all in. I didn't use any transfer tape. I just picked each piece up and placed it over top of what I need to do. That will all be painted the white. Now what we're going to do is we're going to continue on with all of the medium gray, because then we can just paint everything white at the same time. So we're not going to deal with this second ring. We're going to move right on to the third ring. So on sheet six, we're going to be working in these sections in here. You could probably pull these up if you're very, very careful. The only thing you got to be careful about is if the mask folds in half and touches itself, it's almost, it's like crazy glue. It's an instant touch. So I wouldn't, you know, if you're comfortable enough, go ahead and try it. I would probably use the clear on this. And what we're going to do is everything on the next, so the third and the fourth ring, everything starts where these little eyebrows are. So you start in this corner. You run down here and you run tight along here to install this one. So on this side, same thing, right along the eyebrow, running towards the center for this one. Fourth ring, you run along here and then right along the bottom. Same on this side. We'll do it on both sides, and I will get those installed and I'll come right back. Okay, just before I finish up, I just want to show you again what we were talking about on the fourth ring. You're going to start right along this eyebrow and work your way this way to install this one. Now there are these little ridges you have to deal with, so you'll just have to press that down again just before painting. This side you go right up against the eyebrow, follow this line in here, push it in. On the third ring, same thing, right against the eyebrow and go right along the fourth ring and press everything down. On this side against the eyebrow again, right against the fourth ring. And do that. So I'll get the rest of them on, and we'll work on the interior or the inner ring. Okay, so for this inner section, we're going to sheet number five. This is the piece that'll be going in here. I just want to show one little thing here. For those of you who are a little worried about installing masks, what I would do is I always say just cut the clear. But if you cut all the way through, leave the paper back, you can kind of get a feel for how it's going to go. I'm not going to cut the whole thing. I'm just going to kind of give you, just show you what I'm talking about here. So if you were to cut the paper back, then you could actually take this and position this on here and kind of get a feel of where this is going to sit if you're unclear. But we're just going to go ahead and do it. So what I was doing, what I start with this is I start on one of these corners, one of these corners, either this side or this side. And then you can line up coming down towards the front, and then you can lay in the two sides. Again, with all the ribs, it might be a little difficult to pull the clear off, but it'll work. So like I said, just start, I'm going to start on this corner right in here. And kind of line up this side. And then just kind of center it. And then you can pick this up. Like I said, these don't have the lines on them. So all you kind of do is just got to get it fairly close. I mean, these are cut pretty accurate, so. And then just lay it in. Try and rub it the best you can. Like I said, with the ribs, it's going to be a little difficult, but we should be able to get it to work. So just grab the clear and bend it over, and then just hold that piece down just press it into place. Okay, so there's a lot more gray we could do. We can do these two sections in here too, because these are gonna be painted white. This front section will be painted white too, but I think what we'll do is we're gonna just paint this. I don't want you guys to leave too much masking on overnight, even though you could probably leave these on for a couple days, being that there's so many cuts and so little mask touching the model. I think you'd be fine to leave it a couple days. One other thing I forgot to mention is all the painting, what we painted on our model, that's going to be included in the instruction guide. So don't think you have to go through this video all the time and pause it and see what we painted. All those steps are going to be included in the video guide. So I'm going to mask all this off. All of this stuff gets shot with the white. We can pull this all off and then we can continue on with the other ones. Okay, you can see we taped everything off and gave it three light coats of white. So let's pull off the masking tape and see how everything worked out. One thing you'll notice here, what I did is I didn't tape off these little sections in here. Our base coat is white. We were painting white, so a little overspray in there is not going to bother me at all. So even around these little areas in here, all these little lines, we didn't tape off. We just left them just to see how it would work out. All right, well, let's continue taking all this off. Now you might not need to use the razor blade or the razor knife on this. It just depends on how these masks are, but usually they sit really right to the edge. So you should be able to just pick one side up or one corner up. Just find a corner you can get at. So one thing I noticed doing all of these sections all as one, when you're putting the third and the fourth ring together, there's a section, they don't really overlap right here, so you need to tape this little section off just so everything stays that medium gray. Or you just do the outer ring, tape it off, paint it, do the third ring, tape it off, paint it, and work your way that way. That will work too, so. Okay, well, I'll continue removing everything and we'll be right back. All right, all those rings are done. Okay, we'll continue on. We'll do these two front sections here. We're gonna go back to sheet number 6 and put some clear transfer tape on these two. I said, as you get better and better with this, you really don't need to cut it as close. Okay, bring in my magnifying glass. And we'll just place this one on the front. Just kind of pick a corner, whatever corner works for you, and just line it up. Press it down and we're just going to lift up and expose the areas we need to paint white. There's still two little boxes here, and then two on the side we have to pick up. Okay, that's that one. Let's pick up the other one. Those two front pieces. Okay, we can tape these off, give these a coat of white. These two I think will be in the lighter gray, so these will be our last ones in the white. So let's tape those off and get some paint on them. All right, so our coat of white is on. We can now peel all this off and see how it came out. Magnifying glass back in and peel these up. All right, that's that section finished. Okay, well, let's move on. We're gonna finish up ring number two and ring number five. You're gonna have to go to page 6 for those and page 5 for the fifth ring. We'll put some clear on here and we'll come right back and we'll apply them, and then we'll be giving them a paint of the medium gray, and that'll just put the pattern on the white. Okay, so I thought I'd just show you. I'm going to try and just do these masks without the clear, just to see how they work. I think with all the ridges in here, it could be a little difficult to do so, but we're going to try it out. So I'm just going to pull these off very carefully, and I said I don't want them to touch together, but I'm just going to pull my magnifying glass in here. All we want to do is we just want to start on one of the sides, just kind of get it in the corner and work from there. Again, these don't have the lines on them, it's just a pattern we're creating, so it's not really too critical if you don't get it absolutely perfect, but it does fit right where it's supposed to. And then just give it a gentle rub. If you rub too hard, you're gonna wreck some of the Aztec pattern, but it just has to stay in place until we paint it, so it's not that critical. Okay, so let's try the other side. Like I said, I'm not using no clear on this. Just kind of start it or float it into a corner. And I'm just following this line to give me a kind of a guide. I think that works better. I mean, if you put, you can use the clear on it if you wish. The problem with all these ridges that are on here, it's going to be really difficult taking it off. But I think if you're very careful, you can do it this way. Let's try the outer rings and see how those work. That'd be these guys right here. This is probably the toughest one because this is the longest. But I think if you keep it. Just on your fingers so it doesn't touch each other. I'm going to start again at the eyebrow. I'm going to run right in between the third ring and the phaser strip. Just like the other rings, we start at the eyebrow and work our way to the front. Don't pull on these because they will stretch out of place or out of shape. You just want to just kind of just let them fall or lay in or lay down. Okay, well, I think that works out pretty good. I'll finish these off, and then I'm going to tape this off, and we'll come right back just before we paint. Okay, well, we're all masked off. We can give this a coat or three coats of the medium gray. Our medium gray, once again, is going to be one drop of or one part of the deep gray and seven parts of the white. And we'll be right back. Okay, so we've given the whole saucer here three coats of the light gray, so let's take everything off and see how this pattern looks. There's our rings completed. Okay, let's move on. Okay, so we'll move on to the back part of the lower section of the saucer. The first thing we're going to have to do is we're going to have to go to sheet 5. These are the sections we're going to need for that kind of a gill pattern. There's these two outer sides here. These are going to be, just like we did on the top, it's going to be your first mask on there. These are going to be painted the medium gray. Now I know we could have painted the medium gray the same time we did this, but I didn't want to get too much on here for you guys, so we'll just do it in stages. So you can weed these two sections here. These three sections that are here are going to be the medium gray. This section here, you have to, once you put your clear over, you have to cut that off because there's actually a phaser strip that sits right inside there, and then this will allow the mask to sit flush. So let's get some clear transfer. Like I said, I'm not cutting right exactly to it because I can kind of see through the transfer tape where we're going to need to be. But what I want to do is I want to cut the clear where this is. You don't have to be too precise, just as long as we can, as long as that strip will fit through. Just remove the clear. Okay. Let's take this section off. I'm bringing my magnifying glass again. And just position this again right over top of the section that's already been painted the dark gray. So I'll get the other side on. So that one we're going to use to, or this will be painted the medium gray. Okay, so I applied both the masks to these gills. These are the sections, like I said, we're painting the medium gray. I'm going to paint those out and come right back. Okay, so we gave these masks a coat of the medium gray, took the masks off. We can continue on with the other ones. We're going to install these two pieces first. They're going to be the light gray, so I've got to already get the clear on here. Just going to pull this one off. Let me get this magnifying glass out of the way. Okay, so now that our medium gray has been applied to these two sections, we'll work on these two inboard sections here. These have lines on them, so it's just like before, you're going to lay it down and then pull the lines off later. Just two square pieces here we gotta pull out. Just a little piece right in the middle, or right at the end, sorry. Okay, well, I'm gonna get the other piece on and then we'll be right back. Okay, those masks have been applied. Like I said, we're gonna be painting this one the light gray, and also the pieces that go on here now, which are here. These two, we're going to put those on and weed these off. Not this one, just the gill part. We'll weed those, and those will go light gray too. So let's just take these off. And just like we did on the first mask, we're going to cut the clear off of this area here where it goes around the phaser strip. Just position it like before. Just remove the lines now. So this is what I was talking about. If you're lifting off this little line and this little piece on the inside is coming off with it, just grab the outside of the line, just pull it till it tears, and then you can remove it. Okay, that one's on. Okay, so all this, I'll get this other masking on here, and then we're gonna tape everything off and give everything a coat of light gray, and then we'll be right back. Okay, so we shot three coats of light gray, and now we're gonna take off the masking tape and see how we did. Okay, well, there's the gills painted. We have one more section to do. That's these little sections on the aft, and I'll get the masks for those. So these are all in one mask. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna put along the outside, and then we're gonna pull the lines off and we're gonna paint it the white. So let's get some tape. So with these ones, I'd start around the corner here and follow it along the top. It goes right to the outside edge, as close as you can get it. And I'll show you why. Because rather than doing all these little masks, which is almost impossible, we're gonna just do it all as one. Like I said, I don't want to get my head in the way, so hopefully this works out. This one's hard to take off because there are so many little protrusions here. But once you get it off, it'll work. Just flatten everything down. And then we can remove the lines. Slowly work at it, eventually you'll get it. So see how this, there's supposed to be a little line here and it seems to be coming off. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab a toothpick. I'm just gonna hold this part of the mask down and pull this till it breaks. And then come from the other side. That's the piece that was coming off. So we just work from the other side and we'll get her. All right, that's that one. So I'll get the other one on, do the same weeding, and then we're gonna give that a coat of white and we'll be right back. Okay, the white's been applied. Let's take the tape off and the masking and see how this side worked. Okay, well, this side worked. You can see this side didn't work out too good. So what we'll be doing is we're making a few alterations to the mask before the kits are released, but this is where we can actually see where we need to change and where we need to realign. So that will all be done later. That's not a big deal. I'll redo that and reshoot this side. Yeah, we'll make some adjustments there. That'll work. This is a good way to doing it. This way it's a paint test. It's a real life thing. So where we have to make adjustments, this is where we're going to get to do it. All right. So other than the bottom, we're pretty much done other than these two little eyebrows. There's actually a little mask for that too on sheet two. So what we've got here. Is the two eyebrows. So how we work with these is we take one and you can tell which one is which because they're both different. All right, so get my magnifying glass again. Now you just want to center this on top of that triangle, or just kind of put it right on top of the triangle. Peel that off. Now the whole centerpiece comes off. So now on the movie model, this was kind of a dark black, dark gray. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna paint it the same dark gray we have here, and we'll come back and pull the masks off. Okay, so the dark gray's been applied. We can take all the tape off. Now when we did our viewing of the original model, these eyebrows had kind of a white line around them, and that's why this masking makes it pretty easy to do that. You just put that tape on there, and the green tape, you just cover the black a little bit, and then we end up with our white line around it. All right. Well, that concludes the saucer section. We did, we finished the top side of it. I think all the masks are on. All that we can do, if there's any sections that we've missed, they're either too small or too hard to create. But the underside of the saucer is all finished. We will continue on with another video, and we'll start to tackle the engineering hull and the pylons and the nacelles. But until then, follow us on Facebook at Aztec Masking Kit by Mass Design, and follow the other builders. Until then, we'll see you later.